Are we ready? Are you ready, sir?
I am.
I like it. We're going to be sharing microphones here, which is a little awkward, but we're winging it. We're working with what we got. It's Lou McCoy joining you once again from RX17 here in Grapevine, Texas. And I've got a very special guest. Mr. Colin Burns is with us, and he is the creator, the father, the wizard behind Ballistic XLR, something like 4,000 hours into designing this program, correct?
That is. Over 2 years is basically a full-time job in addition to my regular full-time job.
When did you sleep during that time, Colin?
Very rarely. I mean, you only need 4 hours a day, really.
I can't get by on 4 hours, man. I start getting weird, and it's not good.
I was actually, it was a matter of excitement. I wanted to keep working on it, and every time I'd go to sleep, I just woke up and immediately went to my computer, started working on it, and it was just fun for me after a while.
You've got a work ethic like a lot of these guys around here, burning the candle on both ends, and that's kind of what brings us all together today, is because everybody's got ambitions and goals, and we take them seriously. And you, sir, you're kind of a bright guy. I want to say genius, but that might be underselling you a little bit.
I don't like to use the word genius, but I try my hardest to do good work. And some things are easy for me, some aren't. The mathematics was relatively easy, but a lot of it's still actually above me. I got a lot of help out of this from Dr. Arthur Pedsa and Russ Ring and Peter Jackson at Jackson Rifles. They'd done the original work on the source spreadsheet, and I just took it from there and expanded it a tremendous amount. And so what they'd had was originally sort of a neat little small spreadsheet, and I turned it into something just entirely oversized.
That's a good way to put it. For anybody listening or watching today who's not familiar with it, can you explain what Ballistic XLR is, sir?
All right, so we've taken the PEDSA Model G1 Ballistics and implemented it in Excel, and that allows you to use it in the Ballistic XLR version. This is designed mostly for hunters and people who have time to take the time to calculate a shot using Rex's calc form and his overall system. And it compensates for temperature, muzzle velocity, and then all of your various drifts and drops and atmospheric and gravitational effects. So we get spin drift, we get Coriolis, we get horizontal and vertical. We have movers, wind, and then, of course, your drops. And those are all based on what the temperature is. So you get a really fine control across any number of conditions. Ballistic PRS, on the other hand, is meant really for PRS shooters. It is based on density altitude rather than absolute atmospheric density. And so it requires a ton more pages, but there's no calc form necessary for it. So it's really about, do you need fast, then your ballistic PRS? Do you need not so fast, then, and much more flexible, than use Ballistic XLR?
That's fascinating stuff. Where did the inspiration to create this come from?
I was creating another product, actually. I invented a small device, and I was using that to try and characterize the ammunition and the weapon system, and I needed the ability to calculate ballistics so that I could say that the ballistics say that it should have hit here, and then the performance is actually here, and be able to track and trend the weapon, the ammunition, and the shooter independently. That was the whole design of the thing. So I've got a little gadget I've been working on for a number of years, and the coding for it was actually the reason that I did this, is in order to figure out how to code the really, really complicated software for it, I needed to systematize it, and using the spreadsheet seemed like a way that I could understand each piece atomically, and it really worked quite well.
It works perfectly, actually, but your brain works in a different way than mine, sir. Math scares the hell out of me, I'll be honest. Is there any hope for understanding this stuff for guys who aren't into math?
Yeah, I mean, in general, the math that we're dealing with is a simple two functions, mostly addition and subtraction. If you want to get into, you know, sort of the deeper guts of it, well, yeah, there's a lot of calculus involved, but even then, you don't need to understand calculus in order to look into the back end of the spreadsheet and see how things work. Most of it's fairly simple. The hardest parts are the trigonometry.
The trig is harder, huh?
much harder, and it's because you're dealing with sine, cosine, radians, tangents. So it's all of these functions are there, and they're being mixed and matched in interesting ways, and there's numbers are being raised to powers that have decimals in them. That's where things get a little bit more complicated, a little bit more daunting for your average person who hasn't gone through advanced mathematics education in either, you know, calculus in high school or some level of more advanced mathematics in college.
It's all over my head, I'll be honest with you, Colin. I barely made it through trigonometry, but that's why I'm over here and not designing the programs, I guess. Where's your background come from? How do you understand all this stuff so well? Is it just an innate ability, or was there training involved?
It really is an innate curiosity that drove me to develop the skills, and mathematics, numbers in general, have always been a little bit easier for me to deal with than some of the more abstract concepts. Writing software is not really something that is easy for me to do, even though I do some of it, but the math behind it and getting the math into the software was actually the easy part for me, so I just started with that and started working the software around the mathematics, and it made it a lot easier for me to approach. But I have a general interest in any area of applied mathematics or applied physics. So, you know, hot rods, guns, electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, metalworking, carpentry, just all of these things are using math to accomplish some product. And it's always just been fascinating to me. I have an inability to escape it, unfortunately.
Nothing wrong with that, though, man, because math is probably mankind's best tool for understanding the universe and trying to make sense of it all and creating new things as well.
Yeah, I mean, if you think about it, the application of mathematics, especially within ballistics, is creating a model. And the way that we understand our universe in the scientific world is to create a model that's either a mathematic or a theoretical model that may not necessarily include math, but includes some logic. And then you compare that model to observable reality. And if it's right, then you've got a good model. And if you find out it's wrong, then your model needs adjusting. So mathematics is just a system of modeling, in this case, what we find out in the real world, so that we can try and understand it ourselves. It's a little bit like coming to things after the fact. Logic is what you use to explain how you got somewhere after you've already gotten there.
Ballistic XLR, is it, what's a guy got to pay to use the software?
It's absolutely free. You can download it from ballisticxlr.com. Both the Ballistic XLR and Ballistic PRS are completely free, and they're free for you to modify if you want to go out and do that. The only caveat there is, you know, maintain attribution to me and then Russ Ring and Peter Jackson and Dr. Arthur Pejsa, because, you know, all these guys actually put in a ton of really valuable work on it, and what I did was expand on their earlier work. Then support is absolutely 100% free. And you can access that by emailing me at ballisticxlr@gmail.com. And I usually get back to people within a couple hours, if they're getting me within Pacific time, daytime, or even into the evening. If it's not in that kind of window, then it'll be within one day. And so I'm always happy to help. The biggest problem really that I've had is getting people to reach out to me and actually ask for the help. And so it's when they finally get frustrated and they're about ready to quit that they finally reach out. And what I'm hopeful that people will do is reach out right away and let me get them off on the right foot before they even start filling out their inputs.
So you're more than happy to help folks out then?
Yeah, there's no amount of my time that I won't dedicate to this. And that's out of my personal desire that this country return to a nation of riflemen. As means that if you're going to be a rifleman, it's not just a guy who has a rifle. You have to know how to use it. You have to be able to employ it. You have to understand what the application of fire that you're going for is. And so if I can get people down the road just one more step where they're more competent, they're more safe, they're more successful, and they have a good time with it, that can only do better for the sport, for the country, and for freedom in general.
Well, you, sir, are just a hell of a patriot, and hats off to you, man, for what you do, your dedication, and this labor of love. It's amazing. It really is.
Thanks. I really appreciate it. It's something that I don't know what caused me to want to give it away for free, other than I just didn't think it was right to charge somebody for something that I got for free. And then support, there's no reason for me to charge for that, because really I get to meet an insane number of new people in the emails, and some of them have become good friends of mine. And here at RX17, more than 20 different people that had emailed me and I'd never met in person, I finally got to meet in person. It was really, really wonderful. They're actually a huge, great guys. And if I didn't have that, I'd probably feel just a little bit diminished.
Absolutely. And that, it's weird you say that, man, because we all come together here this weekend, and I was nervous at first, and after spending a couple days with these guys, it doesn't feel like a community anymore. It feels more like a big family.
Yeah, it's a bunch of brothers. We all have basically a wide set of outlooks and positions and ideas in our heads, but the thing that we all have in common that brings us together is a love of the sport and a desire to get into it and do something that's really challenging and interesting. And so it's drawn us together under that common purpose. And then we find that the other differences that are out there just aren't actually that different. And even if they are, they become irrelevant.
Amen. At the end of the day, all of mankind, our differences are much, much smaller than our similarities. And if we remember that, it binds us together.
Sure enough, peace can be attained through either superior firepower or by understanding. And so I think we're going on that both directions.
That's awesome. Well said there, Colin. What do you see for the future for Rex? Is he going to be able to do this full time?
I think so. The discipline and the system that he's put together, particularly with the shooting system that he's evolved out of Dean Michaelis's hard target interdiction system, it's amazingly flexible. It's very easy to implement for people of all skill levels. So getting out there and teaching that, especially as long-range riflery, it's getting out of that fad stage into where it's really now a general curiosity. Anybody who owns a rifle is like, well, I don't want to just be limited to shooting deer at 100 yards. I want to be able to reach out and really touch something and to have a personal accomplishment that the rest of the world may not even get the chance to do because they don't have this freedom.
Amen. That's why we love this country, man. Correct me if I'm wrong, but you've talked to Rex for years. Is this the first time you guys have actually met?
In person, yeah. We've spoken on the phone for probably 3-4 years, not regular intervals, but not inconsistently. And a couple of years ago, I went through a pretty rough patch, and I asked him to call me, and he reached out in the spirit of brotherhood. And it really made a difference in my life. And so I think he's possibly one of the greatest people I've ever met. He's put a huge amount of his own dedication, his life, and his resources into doing this. And to meet him in person was really awesome.
And like you, everything he does, he wants to offer it to people for empowerment and betterment and for free, too.
Yeah, and that's the ultimate spirit of fellowship, is to do things for your other man and not expect anything in return. Absolutely nothing. You want them to take this so that they can go and enjoy it themselves. And it's not a self-satisfaction or a personal self-righteousness. It's just the same sort of good feeling you get when somebody smiles near you. And if you can help them smile, that's an awesome day.
Colin Burns, the inventor, the creator, the brain behind Ballistic XLR. It's been a pleasure meeting you this weekend, and I look forward to any communications we have in the future, man. You've been a really solid dude. Any final thoughts for the interview here today, sir?
I got to encourage people to get out there, get your rifles, and stretch your capabilities. Find out what you don't know how to do, and then learn it. If you're afraid, don't be. This isn't hard. It's actually really simple. It's just not easy. The other thing I can say is, if you really want to learn, you really want to pick up riflery or any kind of firearm skills, bow skills, whatever, go out and find a match. You don't go to win, you go to experience. And the thing that you find at a match is you're going to learn, and people are going to teach the heck out of you. And they do it out of the kindness of their heart. And everybody at a match is generally a really great person. You get the odd guy who's just focused on the game and he's there for him. But in general, if you're not on the line firing, we're all back in a group exchanging information and how-tos and techniques and tips and equipment recommendations and things like that. So it's a family that develops. You get out to that match in your area, and you don't need necessarily even to have a gun that's appropriate to it. Show up to the match and ask the match director if he can help you out, and probably somebody will let you use their gun. Pay him a few bucks for the ammo, and volunteer at the range, do some range officer work, help him set targets, do what you got to do, but engage, be part of it. And I think you'll definitely have an amazing time It'll open up entirely new avenues in your life.
You got so much wisdom. I don't think we got enough time to get it all out there, but Colin Burns, thanks so much for being part of RX17, being part of the Rex Reviews podcast, and part of Tiborosaurus Rex's YouTube channel. You've been a pleasure, man. Thank you.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I love being here. This is one of the greater experiences in my life.
To be what you want me to be, to die, I'm blind to me, to feel so powerful without you, to run. Hit.